Okay, this is my second take, by the way. Last time I wasn't recording. Hey guys, welcome to CES 2019. I am here filming for another project, but I could not miss out an opportunity to talk to an astronaut who's launching a pretty cool product, to be honest with you. I'm not really gonna say anymore. I'm just going to take you to our interview and hope you learn something new. Hey guys, I'm here with Scott Parazynski, five-time shuttle astronaut with almost 2 months time, total time in space. Right. Scott is a former, you're never a former doctor.
No, I consider myself still a doc and still an astronaut, even though NASA prefers we call ourselves former astronauts.
And so what are you doing here at CES?
Well, actually, this is a big launch for my company, Fluidity. We have our first product, the FT Aviator, that we're releasing here, and it's a really extraordinary way to fly drones. But actually, what it really represents is a new way to move through physical and virtual space. It's a, you know, you're probably familiar with Xbox controllers, two thumbs used for gaming, for flying drones. Based on my experiences in aviation and flying robotic arms and working in virtual reality environments and in surgical robotics, came up with a way in a single hand to move in up to 6 degrees of freedom of motion. For a drone, we basically need to be able to move up, down, forwards and backwards, left, right, and then yaw left and yaw right. But we can also, with this family of devices, flip inverted and pitch up as well.
Canada arm on the shuttle as well as on the space station has to operate in variable different axes. How do the controls on the station today for the Canada arm compared to what we have here today?
Well, yeah, so what we're really doing is we're controlling the point of reference of whatever it is that you want to control. So in our case, it's the nose of the drone. So we're controlling that with incredible precision and without really having to spend a lot of time thinking about how you're going to get there. This device does it for you. And the same challenges apply in space with the Canada Arm 2 on ISS, which I help assemble with Chris Hadfield on STS-100, by the way. They've got to have incredible precision at the tip of the end effector to capture SpaceX Dragon, to maneuver astronauts around. And so ultimately, this could actually have some possibility of flying up in space.
Why drones?
I love drones. I love aviation. I've crashed a lot of toy drones in the house, and the learning curve is pretty challenging. You know, using your two thumbs, and there's a lot of cross-coupling, inadvertent motions that happen based on using the traditional controls. This is an enormous and growing industry, and so we decided we would go for the drone marketplace first.
And I know for myself, I'm a filmmaker, I'm a video producer and director, and I see amazing applications for this in the cinematography business. Right. You don't need a lot of fast movement, we just need precision.
We actually spoke to many of your colleagues, you know, trying to understand the use cases and making it really high performance for them. So we actually have unique features built into this to allow you to move fast when you want to move fast, but then to be able to dial it down on the fly and to move in jello, and also to be able to adjust the sensitivity of the tilt so you get that perfect take the first time. Because, you know, the battery life on drones is not that great. You don't want to fly multiple batteries to get that one perfect shot.
Yeah, it's amazing. Well, how about we go try fly a drone?
Let's do it.
All right. Yeah. So, Scott, what are we doing here?
We're flying a drone, and we're flying it in the most intuitive, precise way imaginable, and it's going to be a revolution for enterprise pilots, people who use these things professionally, but also if you just want to go out and have some fun. So you can fly this thing with almost no training and get exactly where you want to go. Really, basically, all I'm doing is considering the tip of my thumb, the nose of the drone, and I can fly almost subconsciously, doing maneuvers that would take weeks to really master with a twin stick kind of controller. So just to kind of show you how it works, if you want to climb, you can either pull up with your thumb or pull in with your index finger and you ascend, press down and you descend. Twist for yaw, right or left. You can press forwards or backwards, and then you can go left or right with pitch and roll.
So Scott, I'm going to be honest with you. I've never flown a drone before.
You will not crash this.
I won't.
Ready to try?
All right. I'm going to ask you to hold the mic, though. I'm sorry. You're going to be my production assistant now.
All right. There you go.
All right. So this is to go up. Oh,
yep.
Wow. All right. Yep. And then we got...
Press down.
And, oh, wow. It's very... It's what you expect. And then... Oh, my God.
It's mapped to just your thumb.
Now, the more I've only done this for a couple seconds, but all I want to do is go fast now. Look at that.
See, automatically you're doing a perfect descending spiral.
Yeah.
that's really tough to do with the joysticks. In fact, if you see up here in the upper corner, this is what you'd have to be doing with the equivalent twin sticks. Very, very difficult to master. Hundreds of hours of training.
So I've been doing this for a minute, and I feel insanely comfortable. And it's also something that has been a struggle, I think, for people who are new to drone flying, is that it's this object out in the distance, you know, and now you have to learn a new hand control, and it's not like you're on board where you see perspective, so it can be kind of difficult to coordinate. Where with this, as long as I can remember where the front of the drone is, it's pretty seamless. Well, Scott, this has been really exciting. I don't want to take up any more of your time, but I really appreciate what you're doing here. You are a space legend, so five-time shuttle astronaut is extremely rare. So you're in a very small club.
It's great to be in the club for sure.
All right, Scott. Well, thanks a lot, man. Hope you guys enjoyed the interview. I want to say special thanks to Scott. He was super nice and super friendly. I wasn't lying that I never flown a drone before. I picked it up instantly. While I have your attention, before you go, don't go. Please don't go. I meant to take my shirt off earlier. I know. I meant to take my shirt off earlier because I am wearing my shirt from sfsf.shop from Michael. There it is. Ta-da. I'm promoting this shirt because the proceeds of every shirt sale that I would typically get is being donated to a nonprofit of my choice, and that's the Iraq and Afghanistan Veterans Association. They help lobby for legislation for the benefit of veterans. I don't make a penny from this, and that's really all I got to say. So I hope you enjoyed the video. Please subscribe to my channel. I feel weird having this whole unbuttoned thing, so I'm just gonna double down on taking it off, and yeah. I'll see you guys later.